Power 106.7.
Live and direct.
Let's go.
Hey, this is J-Ro and Double J. I love your face.
And there it is. Jay, how are you this morning?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing good. I'm excited because me personally, I'm getting ready to go on vacation. I'm going to take my wife to Puerto Rico soon. And I was thinking about this and I said, I know you guys have been to Italy, but where's the coolest place that you have gone on vacation since your celebrityism has kicked in, so to speak?
I went to St. Martin because I work with Australian Gold with my tanning line.
Right.
And I had to do a photo shoot out there on the French side, and they own a house. So because I did the shoot there, they gave me the house for a week, like a compound of, like, just pure, I don't even know what to call it. Just, like, the most wonderful place I've ever been in the world.
J-Wa, I believe we call that heaven.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it was just, like, no one was there. It was insane wait staff. It looked like a hotel, but it was only for me and Roger.
Right.
And actually, we brought one of my friends that got married recently, and Ron and Sam from the Jersey Shore came. So we just had the best time.
You know, I was talking with Ronnie a couple months ago, and I asked him, I said, who did you dislike the most in the house from Jersey Shore? And he told me that probably the situation, Mike was probably the biggest douchebag in the house. Would you agree with Ronnie on that?
Well, I don't know. I always take things from, like, because Ronnie had issues with Mike, with Sam, and that
right.
whole problem.
Right.
So, you know, between, you know, Mike had a lot of problems with Nicole and Ronnie and Sam because of, you know, them hooking up the first season. So I never actually had, like, a legitimate problem with anyone except for when I backhanded Mike.
Right.
Season one. And ever since I kind of punched him in the face, we've been cool. I mean, I still talk to everyone, but the person I least talk to is Mike.
What about the Staten Island dump? You and her friends?
Oh, yeah. I forgot about her. Yeah, I haven't talked to her.
Who would you say fights more as a couple? You and Roger or Snooki and Gianni?
Definitely me and Roger.
What do you guys fight about?
It's not like we fight about anything of importance. It's the fact that we're both type A personalities.
Right.
We want to prove that we're right. And Nicole and Gianni are very passive. So, you know, they'll let things go. And me and Roger will go to war over it. Like, we don't care. It's like, let's throw down.
Over little things like, I told you 9 ice cubes and there's 7 in here.
Oh, 100%. Like, yesterday. Like, yesterday it was, I was changing, like, the Swiffer batteries.
Right.
There was 2 batteries left on the counter that were in the drawer, but they didn't work, so I changed them again. And Roger comes in like, oh, are these batteries dead? I go, yeah. He goes, they're from the Swiffer. I said, no. He goes, well, where the hell did they come from? I was like, the drawer. He's like, no, you took them out of the Swiffer. I said, no, F. I didn't take them out of the Swiffer. They're from the drawer. You put dead batteries in the drawer. And we started fighting about that because he swears that he wouldn't put dead batteries in the drawer.
I mean, that's a pretty dumb thing to fight over. What's the dumbest thing you guys have gotten in a big argument and fight over?
Oh, I mean, like, that's just, like, daily. Like, last night, I wanted to go see Gravity, but on the way to the movie theater, I dozed off. And, you know, he'll make a snide comment like, ooh, real quality time we're spending together. I'm like, shut your face. See what I mean?
If you just tuned into the program, we're talking with J-Wow this morning. It is Double J in the morning on Power 106.7. You and Roger, so you fight a lot.
Like, we just, like, go back and forth like that. But I think that's what keeps our relationship entertaining. Because I honestly wouldn't have it any other way. I feel like I'd get bored really quick.
Growing up, did you always have to date somebody with a lot of muscles?
Well, I tried. I tried that one time when the show first started with
right.
Tom.
Yeah.
I tried to just date a normal guy, and yeah, that, you saw where that got me. Nowhere.
Now, there's a lot of rumors going around right now saying that you've had a lot of plastic surgery. Let's put in the rest right now. Have you ever had plastic surgery?
Yeah, I had my boobs done.
That's not plastic surgery. That's a blessing.
Yeah, thank you. Hello, Dr. Greenberg.
LB's talking about nose jobs. There were rumors going around that you got nose jobs.
Oh, my God. If you put... Oh, hell no. Actually, and you know what? I'm not against... I actually never even heard the nose job one, but I have the same nose, and you can see, I mean, clear as day that I do from, like, old pictures. The thing is, like, 22 years old, like, I walked in... I would say about 10, 15 pounds more than what I am now.
Yeah.
And I learned how to do makeup through professional makeup artists. So they've changed my look hugely. Like, my makeup artist is a drag queen. But I always say like this with people. Like, remember Christina Aguilera, like, 15 years ago when she was, like, really thin?
Yeah.
And, you know, pretty, like, in a different way?
Yep.
And now she has, you know, she's a little meatier. But if the role was reversed and she came out bigger than when she was and then lost all the weight, a lot of people would claim that she had plastic surgery as well.
How do you deal with people like Jimmy Kimmel, Joe McHale on The Soup that are always constantly taking pop shots at you guys?
Oh, my God, I love it. I feel like that's an honor. My dad is, like, Joe McHale's number one fan. Like, my dad gets ripped on that show all the time.
Right.
And he'll record it on his phone and send it to me. And he's like, all I want to do is meet him. Can you just send me out to L.A. to meet him once? I actually agree with my father. And me and Nicole, like, I'll never forget, like, when they made the Schnooky or whatever it's called, like, Smush Mush on the cartoon.
South Park.
I was sitting with Nicole, and we've never laughed so hard in our lives. Like, you have to, like, even with the plastic surgery, like, as long as you're comfortable with yourself, you can get made fun of. Like, there's nothing wrong with that. You can get talked about. There's nothing wrong with that either, because that means you're doing something right. Like, I find it to be, like, an honor that, you know, Jimmy Kimmel and them have enough time, or they actually think we're important enough to be made fun of.
Snooki and J-Well premieres tomorrow night at 8 o'clock Mountain Time here in Albuquerque on MTV. Are you constantly on Twitter?
Oh, yeah.
Do you tweet people back, or are you one of the celebrities who just says, follow me on Twitter, but I'm never going to answer your tweets?
I'm actually having a live chat today at 3 p.m. with my followers.
Follow J-Wow, and it's at Jenny Wow, W-O-W-W, and then tomorrow night on MTV, Snooki and J-Wow premieres. Thanks so much, J-Wow. We appreciate you hanging out with us this morning.
And that's how it's done.
Wake up, wake up,
wake up with
Double J in the morning.
Get up, get up, get up.
Weekday, 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Power 106.7.